guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. If you guys have a BMW that does not start cranks but doesn't start, we will show you guys how to fix that. We will guys have more than 200 videos on this car. Our mission guys is to save you as much money as we can. So please guys, in return, hit that subscribe button, like the video and leave a comment below. Let us know if the video was helpful. So we'll demonstrate how this one doesn't start. We will show you what could be one of the most common reasons for that and how to fix it. So let's go ahead and start on it now. So we're inside this BMW now guys. I'll attempt to start it, listen what's going to happen. Nothing guys, it doesn't start. Now, first thing that I do, when I turn the key on, okay, you're supposed to hear the fuel pump guys. Usually the fuel pump will be right behind, right here, underneath the vehicle, in front of the rear tire, under the seat. You'll be able to hear the fuel pump running inside the vehicle if you carefully listen and you're at a quiet place. And the fuel pump should make a buzzing sound for about a second or two. You say bzzz, and you know it's running and then it will quit. So I will turn the key on and try to listen. Listen now. Okay, I don't hear guys. I don't hear the pump working on this car. So what could be guys, okay, what could be the reason for that? Now, first, okay, we're going to cover everything from start to finish. You have a few relays, you have a few fuses that we need to check. Stay until the end, we'll show where the fuel pump relay is located because it's very, very hidden. Now, right here guys, on the front, doesn't matter which engine you have, we have guys, okay, we have the fuse box. Okay, let me get there quick. This cover, okay, usually is like that. Let me install it to show you what you need to do. Okay, like that, the cover is like that, and you need to get 1, 2, 3, 4 screws loose with Torx 25 star looking bit, and then you lift it up, pull it out. Now, what we need to check guys, those are very important fuses. Okay, very important fuses, and those are for engine management. This is for an engine computer, you have fuses, you have for ignition coils which start the car and stuff like that. So you need to check all of these fuses guys. How you do that? Okay, we're going to show in just a second. So with a small screwdriver, okay, there is one clip that we need to pry out here, and we're going to pull the fuse box, that fuse block out. Okay, like that. Now, some of those fuses are very important. Ignition coil fuse, if it doesn't work, the car is not going to start. Also, you have engine computer fuse, you have the fuse for the fuel pump relay, but not the relay itself, all that is here guys. And I usually get a voltmeter, those are individual fuses that you can replace by opening that cap. You have two things that you need to slide back, okay, and you can open and replace the fuses, but I get a voltmeter, set it to continuity testing. And I'm going to test each of the fuses because those are super important fuses. If the fuse is good, it will show that we have connection and it will go close to zero here. Check this thing out now. Zero. Here. Zero. On this one. Again. So far those fuses are good guys. Okay. You can see. No problems here. Now, what else could be causing the problem guys? If you don't hear your fuel pump, what I'm going to do, I'll show you where you need to go now. Okay, we need to check a relay. Okay, that's hidden guys. Okay, and you will need to remove, okay, for that purpose, you will need to remove your glove box. Remove the glove box, okay. And the relay is super hidden. But before we get to it, in the regular fuse box, you have one fuse for the fuel pump as well. We have a fuse for the fuel pump, so check it out. We'll have it on the channel if you need to check out which one it is. But most likely guys, we have a bad relay in our case. So once you remove your glove box, you have one nut that you need to remove here with a 10 mm. You can pull that thing down a little bit. Okay, and now I will be able to get to the relays. Okay, and I will be able to pull that thing out. Okay, this is the relay guys for the fuel pump. Okay, right there. So I'm going to go ahead and replace it. We have a video on how to test one as well guys. It's very helpful information. Always you can check out where we get them from, and we'll show you if that fixes the problem now. So I'm getting the new relay now. I'm going to go ahead and install it. Okay, it goes only one certain way. It's super super limited room in here. So I'll go ahead, install it, and we'll see if that's going to take care of the problem. So with the new relay installed, okay, I'm going to go ahead and see if I can hear the pump now. Definitely guys heard that noise now. I'm going to go ahead and attempt to start the car. Okay, it fired right up with no problem. So this is it guys, you can see that fuel pump relay was the case why this BMW didn't start. So thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe to the channel for more videos and see you guys next time.